Hello, Brian Krause here, and you're probably wondering, why am I at Castle Neuschwanstein here? Well, today I want to talk to you about an overlooked process that holds the keys to the entire kingdom on your computer. This is something known as the LSASS process. What LSASS stands for is Local Security Authority Subsystem Service. And this is a process that is on every Microsoft Windows operating system. And it is responsible for enforcing security policies on that system. In particular, it verifies users logging onto a Windows computer server. It's gonna handle password changes. And ultimately, it's gonna create access tokens. Now, what's important about this, it is holding passwords, credentials, hashes, and other keys used to make access across the Windows domain in memory on a laptop. So if somebody is able to gain access to that information, they definitely can do some pretty nefarious attacks. If you want to see this process running live on your own machine, it's relatively easy to do, is go to your task manager. Everybody knows how to do that. You're going to right-click on the local security authority process, and then you create a dump file. This dump file is literally just a file. If you click on it, it's going to be encrypted, so you won't be able to see anything inside of it. However, there is a handy little program called Mimikatz. This is something that is part of every pen tester's toolkit, and unfortunately, every hacker's toolkit. And what can be done with a tool of this nature is within something like PowerShell, or this can be done on Linux, whatnot, you put in some different commands, and ultimately this piece of software goes in, looks into that LSASS dump file, and it gives you the credentials. So here we can see that there's some NTLM hashes, some SHA hashes. It looks like we have something, an administrator account to the domain. And now what can be done is you can actually use those hashes, so that line of text and numbers, and insert that into a running process to be able to access something like the domain controller, which clearly is a very bad thing. Or we'll even see there's another one where they give you the username and password clear text. You know, that then leads us to the question of what should you do now? You know, this nice little children's book will tell you that not chase balls into the street. However, I want to talk about security, computer security in particular. And first and foremost, it starts by restricting access to the local admin account. From there, it's really a great idea to make sure that you're controlling the processes that various applications can access on your computer. Of course, if you're restricting access to the local admin account, you're not going to be able to install software. Not necessarily a good thing from a user perspective. Therefore, you need to make sure you have the ability to provide just-in-time access so there is a good user experience, i.e. your machine works and is usable. Now, in order to provide this just-in-time access, applying MFA across the machine is very important because this is really the only way you can ensure it's a correct user. And of course, if you're not sure how to do this, you can always call a guy like me, and I'm here to help.